the last time she was seen around 7 a.m. on a school morning. With me right now, her father, Maurice Dubois, is joining us. Mr. Dubois, our thoughts and our prayers are with you and your family.
Thank you.
Amber had never run away from home before, correct?
Absolutely not.
You saw her, as I recall, on February the 6th. What were her spirits?
Great. She was in a great mood. We went out to the movies, went out and fed the ducks at the park like we typically do, me, her, and my niece. She was in a great spirits.
Was there any suggestion she was unhappy at home?
No, absolutely not. No, typical home life. I mean, I'm not going to paint a golden picture. I mean, everything's great there. I mean, she loves her house. She loves her life. Great friends. No problems.
Mr. Dubois, what are police telling you?
Basically, they're continuing their investigation. You know, they're following up on leads that come in. There's been no concrete leads, nothing significant that can help us find her at this point.
Have you spoken to Amber's school? Is there any way they can help? She was 300 yards from school. Mm-hmm. She had about a mile walk to school. That's what I had when I was a little girl.
Yeah.
You'd think in 1 mile she'd be safe. Take a look at this. Just 1 mile from her home to the Escondido High School.
That's correct. Even less than that, I would probably say it's closer to a half mile than a mile.
And it's all residential.
Absolutely.
It just seems to me that at that time there would be a lot of kids walking to school. She was only 300 yards from the doorstep.
That's correct. Yeah.
Joining me right now is Bill Garcia, a private eye there in California that's helping the family. Bill, what more can you tell me?
Good evening, Nancy. We're continuing our investigation along with the Escondido police. We've had a lot of leads come in since the tip line has been initiated. There's a lot of people that have concern for Amber's whereabouts, and the community has come together to bring her home.